ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா. குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குரு சாட்சாத் பரம் பிரம்ம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம. ஐ எம் சீயிங் லெஸ் லைட் ஹியர், மேக் லிட்டில் மோர் லைட். The front one you can make. Agrawal ji? He's looking very dark. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya. Haan, better. Ye yahan ki light upar kar dena samne wali. It is here, it's not there. Bada bada.
Aur koi light nahi hai. This is it.
Theek hai phir. Am I audible to all? Good. Now settle. Before reaching to this holy place, we were having a lot of thoughts that I had to get up early in the morning, get up and get ready, and then I had to take a cup of tea, whether something is available there or not, how much time it will take, is the traffic all right? So many questions, and those questions were valid till we reach this place. Isko bhi bada dijiye. So, and make it more. And the moment we have reached here, better. Now asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya. So when we reached here, thereafter all those questions disappeared, is it not? What is the reason? The reason is we started our journey from a point where we were, and we reached the destination where we want to reach. So, GPS functions with these two points, point of origin and the destination that we have to reach. Till the time we reach the destination, we have 101 thoughts, disturbances in the mind, questions, doubts, arguments, logic, possibility, so many of them. But the moment we reach the destination, there are no questions, no doubts, no disturbances, no arguments, no logic, because you are reached. If this principle is clear, so what will be the sign of abiding in truth? What will be the signs of living in meditation 24/7? The science will be, you will be left with no questions, no doubts, no arguments, don't want to know anything, because you already reached. If you go to any medical doctor, you know, the surprising thing is, when you go to the animal doctor, you know what happens? If you have gone sometime, they write the name of the owner of the patient. See? Santosh Agrawal. Disease. Dood nahi deti. So the disease pertains to the buffalo, and the owner is the man. But when we go to the human doctor, it is different. We go to the doctor and we tell. What do we tell? We tell the symptoms. Unless you are a typical Indian, you will tell the symptoms. Indians tell the doctors what they should do. These are the typical signs of being an Indian. Every Indian is expert in somebody else's job. Every Indian is a born doctor. Every Indian knows everything except his own job. See, he can advise even to God. Typical signs of Indians. So when we go to the doctor, we tell him the symptoms. These are the symptoms. Now from these symptoms, we reach the disease. This is the disease, is it not? Now apply the same principle. If you are abiding in the truth, meaning if you have reached the destination, then you have no questions about destination. Exactly the same way. Lesser the questions you entertain, nearer you are to your own self. This understanding is living in meditation. Number two, we all have questions about everything which is other than ourselves. See? We don't have question about ourselves. So if we are abiding in the self, what will be the net result of our life? We will have zero questions and we will be at peace with ourselves. This is what is meditation. You are not struggling. You are not achieving anything. And you are not losing anything. Achievements and losses are zero only in the infinite. Infinite plus minus anything continues to be infinite, is it not? But we are constantly entertaining so many questions, doubts, arguments, logic. Why? Because the sky is too high. See, my friends, then the third principle is, when we have questions and doubts and problems and disturbances, instead of asking why this is so, ask to yourself, to whom it is? Who is disturbed? Who is miserable? Who is worried? Who wants to know? We will precipitate on a point that there is somebody who wants to know. When there is nobody, no thoughts. No thought can erupt without the seed of somebody. There has to be somebody to have a thought. See, friends, thoughts do not come from the mind of its own. Thoughts come from the seed of somebody. In deep sleep also, the mind is. And because of the presence of the mind in the deep sleep, our life is maintained. The blood circulation goes on. The digestion continues. No problem. But most important thing, in deep sleep, there is nobody. So what is meditation? Living as nobody. See, the other day, somebody asked me this question. Swamiji, why you people insist that the child should have the father's name as a middle name in Gujarat, in Maharashtra, in many places? Why you insist? Like you take, all of you know, Mahatma Gandhi, M.K. Gandhi. Mohandas, his name. K. Karamchand, his father's name, Gandhi. Why father's name is required? The baby is delivered by the mother. In USA, this is a tradition, is it not? You write only the mother's name. So this question was asked to me. Why this is so? I said, forget about it. It's like that. No, I want to know. Why you insist? What is the father's name? It is not the law in this country. We don't write father's name. Mother's name is enough. I said, very good, continue. No, but I want to know why you write. I said, if I tell you something, it will hurt you. And if I tell something, after that, no discussions. Agreed? He said, yes. No discussion, zero discussions. Agreed. I said, because we know who is the father. When you have doubt, how will you write who is the father? Be attentive. Do we call bull's son calf or cow's calf? We call cow's calf. We don't call bull's calf because we don't know which bull. In animals, the fatherhood is confused, doubtful. In cultured human beings, the fatherhood is perfect. And therefore, we write father's name. The second point. Every plant, every tree comes from the earth. You sow a mango seed. You sow a tomato seed. You sow a chili seed. Three types of plants will come. Will we call these are the plants of earth? The plants are born out of the seeds. The seed grows, not the earth. See, my friends. So when there is somebody, then the thoughts come. So be very attentive. Now the question comes, how the somebody is born? See? And for that, we have to analyze our own experiences. The real meditation begins when we are able to analyze our every experience of life and grow wise. Not by asking questions. Discover yourself. Then we will come to know this somebody is the culprit. So meditation is working on this somebody. See, there was one international yoga conference in Lonavala, Mumbai, near Mumbai. They gave me three talks. And the topic given was simplifying life. And in that, I have mentioned, I said, what is mistaken by the modern world? They are simplifying living. They are not simplifying life. See, what is simplifying living? We wanted to operate on those lights which are far away at the ceiling, which we can't reach. So what is simplification? From the distant remote control, it is operated and work is done. Simplification of the operations. I want to switch off my fan at home, but I am at work. Then from your phone, you can switch off. Simplification of living. You want to put your rice for cooking, and when it is cooked, it should be switched off. Simplification of living style. It is not simplification of life. What is simplification of life or simplifying life? You are least dependent. See how many things we are dependent in life. I tell you my own example. How I have become a slave. Not today, but last more than 30-40 years, I have been living very comfortable life. Wherever I had gone, by God's grace, got very nice comfortable beds, AC rooms, cars, AC, everything comfortable. Slowly, slowly, that body got adapted to such an extent that if the bed is not proper, I don't get sleep. Because dependence. This is not simplifying life, this is simplifying living. Once we understand this principle, that we have become the slave. Now, who is this who has become the slave? This we have to find out. Then we will come to know. We are somebody always, whenever thinking process is going on. So first learn how the thoughts begin. Now for that, we do small experiments. These experiments I have always done in many of my talks. And I am so happy nobody follows them. That is how my market is maintained. I don't want you to grow wise, continue to be miserable, so that my market is maintained. See, as you are sitting perfectly, no change in your posture. Don't become serious. Become parents or children and observe what kind of thoughts erupt in your mind. Stop. Now, second experiment. Become husband or wife and see what kinds of thoughts erupt in your mind. Stop. Last experiment. Remain as nobody. Stop. Now listen and let us analyze our experiments. First, when we became parent or children, the thoughts were pertaining to children or parents. If you have become a father, you are thinking about your children. If you are a child, thinking about your father. When you became a husband, thoughts were pertaining to your wife. When you were a wife, thoughts were pertaining to the husband. And when you were nobody, no thoughts. You know what is our struggle in meditation? The struggle in meditation is like this. One example I'll give you. Once we were in Goa, and I was on the sea beach and taking bath in the sea. About half a dozen kids with me, we were enjoying play. And there was one gentleman, he came, he wanted to also probably swim, put on the towel and ready to get into the sea. So waiting. I said, come on man, how long are you going to wait? Get in. No, I am waiting till the waves stop. I said, whole life, you can stand there as a statue. The waves will not stop. See, to imagine that ocean will be without the waves is something like this. To imagine as somebody, we will be at peace. As somebody, you have to be disturbed. As nobody, you can never be disturbed. So what is meditation? Meditation is, we have to learn the art of coming to the position of delete somebody and install nobody. See, the moment you understand these basics, then the real meditation begins. Otherwise, normally people have got these funny notions about meditation. Meditation for high blood pressure, meditation for constipation, meditation for disturbed mind. Ram, 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 Ram. It is something like gym for spondylosis, weightlifting for fractured ribs. See, meditation is not a curative method. It is not a place where unhealthy people are admitted. All my satsang, I call them as the gyms. There are following places where people gather. First, entertainment. They pay through nose and suffer silently or loudly. Huge crowds. See, any Hollywood, Bollywood dumb fellow comes, how much crowds you will get. Then the second place where many people come together is the hospitals. Nobody is invited in the hospital, but huge crowds. And they pay there. The third place, temples, pujas, where they come for fulfilling their desires. Oh God, if I do this thing, let my daughter get married. Oh God, if I let me get a job. But when you come to a gym, you will see, to any gym you go, there will be 25 machines standing there and waiting. Please somebody come, please somebody come. And facilities are available 24/7. Get 1% enrolled, 2% free. And yet nobody goes. Because who can go to gym? Those who are healthy and those who want to maintain their health. But normally this is what has come to the knowledge, that we go to the satsanga and then my backache will go. Go to satsanga, then my son will start listening to me. This is unhealthy understanding of spiritual life. You sort out your problems by wisdom. Problems are born because of wrong thinking. Wrong thinking can be corrected by right understanding. Not by right thinking, right understanding. See? But normally what the yoga or meditation they mean yoga means what? You should not think. And then only struggle that stupid person does, that, Swamiji, whenever I sit for meditation, there are too many thoughts, what should I do? Don't do meditation, relax. No, but my guru told, do meditation, then do meditation. No, but then the thoughts come, then don't do meditation. You decide what you want. But why the bad thoughts come in meditation? Because of meditation. Don't do that. See, my friends, now the question is simple. If somebody goes to an ENT specialist and tells the doctor, oh doctor, I can hear with my ear properly. Doctor will say, why you have come, go away. We go to the ophthalmologist and tell that I can see the things very clearly. Then go away, why you have come? Because eyes are meant to see, ears are meant to hear. In the same way, where the thoughts should come? Thoughts will come in the mind. And that is our complaint. Should the thoughts come in the nose, you can blow them out. Think, friends. Because of this wrong understanding, meditation has become a big business. And then there are courses. First level course in meditation, second level course in meditation, and the one which I saw in UK, crash course in meditation, where you are crushed. See, friends, wherever spirituality becomes an earning platform, it is not spirituality. Simply chanting the mantras have no meaning. Na karmana na prajaya dhane na tyagi naiki amrutattva manasho parena na kamnitam guhayam vibrajate yadyatayo vishanti vedanta vidyana sunishchitartha sanyasa yoga adyateha shuddha sattvaha. Not by wealth the truth is attained, the lecture is given. But before you join the lecture, you have to pay $5,000 for the first row. See, my friends, to whom are we cheating? On spiritual path, money can never be the topic of discussion. Therefore, if we really want to be at peace with ourselves, so what is the meaning of meditation? We are at peace with ourselves. Such a person alone is at peace with the whole world. A person who is at war with himself, he cannot be at peace with others. See, my friends, and what is being peace with ourselves? We are not a problem to ourselves. Because we are a problem to ourselves, we want to run away from ourselves. And how do we run away? Either we take a book to read, or we want a cereal, or we go for a movie, or we want to listen to some music, or we want to do something. Because we are not ready to face ourselves. And then we want to run away. But where will you run away? Wherever you go, there you are. Think, my friends. Therefore, what is meditation? Meditation is this so simple. We are at peace with ourselves. And a person who is at peace with himself or herself is living in meditation 24/7. Now, what is the meaning of being at peace with oneself, going to a forest or in a cave? No, that is being dead. What is the meaning of being at peace with oneself? Can there be some example? Yes, there is. Like what? Water is at peace. Whether it is in the form of the ocean, or in the form of a wave, or in the form of an iceberg, or in the form of a cloud or in the form of a steam. Water is at peace. In the ocean, the waters do not drown. When the waves break, water doesn't break. When the water is heated, water doesn't become miserable. It absorbs. So, what is the meaning of being at peace with oneself? We are wherever we are supposed to be, and yet we remain undisturbed. Like, if your wife is very good, understanding, intelligent, sacrificing, just imagination, and therefore you are happy, then what is your contribution? But if your wife is a terrible one, a nagging one, a dumb one, demanding one, shouting one, and yet you are happy, then you are a genius. Then you are living in meditation. See, my friends, so like the water is at peace under all conditions, a person living in meditation is at peace under all conditions. But for most of the people, half an hour meditation, rest of the day frustration. And their objection is, see, I am doing so much of meditation, but people don't understand. Right? It is something like this, you know, I have taken food, but people are hungry. See, my friends, therefore, to bring the whole thing together, whatever we have thought so far, problems begin with the seed of somebody. Unless you correct this basic error, all what you are doing is only trying to write Ram Nam on the flowing Ganges waters. The rivers are flowing, and you take a stick and write there, Ram. Oh, where it has gone? Exactly the same way. See, friends, Vedanta or meditation is not replacement of notions. In all other paths, it is replacement. In Dharma, path of karma, earlier I was lazy, but now I am dynamic. Earlier I was drinking wine, now I drink dudhu milk. Earlier, I was eating non-vegetarian. Now, I go for a grazing along with the cows. Then I still maintained. See? Earlier, I was a bhogi. Now, I am a yogi. Earlier, I used to wake up 10 o'clock. Now, I wake up at 9:45. See? This is not meditation. Wrong notions are removed without creating new notions. See? And wrong notions are at the thought level. So we have to correct the thought level wrong notions. And therefore, we have to think. In yoga, they talk about yogaha chitta vritti nirodaha. They talk about suspension of thought formation. Why we should be afraid of thoughts? Control the thoughts, guide the thoughts, direct the thoughts, and get out of the thoughts by the help of the thoughts. That is meditation. See? But like there are painkillers in allopathy. What is the painkiller which kills you without pain? They are not killing the pain. Painkillers are not curative medicines. These antidepressant drugs, they are not curative. They are only suppressing the mind under compulsion. The moment the drug effect is gone, again it starts bumping out. Yoga is like that. Contrary to that, correct your thinking process. See, and then you will come to discover one important point of meditation. Thoughts happen only to somebody. Now find out how this somebody is born. We are all disturbed and miserable, always as mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, in-law, outlaw, children. We are all disturbed as that. Now the question is, how these fellows are born? So let us start analyzing our own experiences. In deep sleep experience, we are nobody. And therefore, we are happy. And therefore, we snore. Happiness is always expressed as noise, is it not? Can somebody be happy with a frowning face? What happened to you? I am happy. No. When you are happy, you blasted, ha 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 ha. So, because you are happy. In the same manner, in deep sleep you are so happy that you start snoring. So the snoring is a sign of a happy sleep. Those who cannot snore, they are miserable. See, try to snore when you are awake. You cannot, because you are not happy. How simple it is. Now the next step. When you are in deep sleep, you are nobody because you are not identified with your body. In deep sleep, who are we? Man, woman, young, old, rich, poor, husband, wife, brother, sister, mother, father, nobody. First of all, who are we? Nobody. Where are we? Nowhere. Like yesterday I came and after having food, I slept. So I told Ravi, I sleep for about half an hour, then we can go for a walk. And I slept as if it is a dead wooden log. Poor fellow came 3-4 times, tried to wake me up. But who cares? I was in such a deep sleep. So I was nobody, I was nowhere. And when I got out of the sleep, I saw the problem about time. Miami time different and Houston time different. So I was struggling whether it is 7 o'clock or 6 o'clock. 7 o'clock and again I slept. So when you are not identified with the body, you are nobody, you are nowhere, and you have transcended the time. What is living in meditation? The time, space and objects do not influence you. That is living in meditation. When we want, we should have the freedom to wake up. When we are taking food, we should have the freedom to stop. Thus far, not further. No, today's food is very good. Dabao. And afterwards, too much. I can't control yourself. See, we have to start living in utter awareness. Therefore, start analyzing your experiences. In deep sleep, we are nobody, nowhere, nothing. We have no possessions, we have no relations. Therefore, we are happy. So what is meditation? Meditation is, whenever you are sitting, start with this. I am sitting here as a happy being. Beginning is this way. We'll do it systematically. We have got 5 days, isn't it? Okay. Then second thing, When we are identified with the body, then alone somebody is born. See, technically it is called a mithyatma. Mithyatma means what? That which appears but which is not. I was in Mexico recently, last 18 days, and we moved in many places where Mayan culture is there. I was very enchanted by the Mayan culture. So I wanted to study what it is. And after seeing all that, then my friend asked me, what is the Maya, Maya, the Mayan culture? I said, Maya means what? Ma means not. Ya means that. That which is not, yet it appears, is equal to Maya. Like the blue color of the sky appears to be blue, but it is not blue. And although you know it is not a blue color, yet you will continue to see it as a blue, is it not? So what is the blue color of the sky? It is Maya. Exactly the same way. Our body is not created by us. We may claim, I am a self-made man. But the body you have not created, yes. Now we have not created the body, and the body doesn't listen to us. There are people who want to shed the fat, but when they look at the ice cream picture, they put on 5 kilos without any understanding why. The other person, they are all Agarbatti brand. Even if they eat the live buffalo, they will be continue to be only Agarbatti. Why? The body doesn't listen to us. So body is not created by us, body doesn't listen to us. And yet I am body, and we are wise. Think, friends. Therefore, this body notion is the culprit because of which the samsara and the problems continue. If we have come to this point, then next point. After body identification, then somebody is born. Mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, all these fellows are born. So now these are the three stages. As nobody, we are happy. As body, we are healthy, unhealthy. Born, going to die. And as somebody, we are miserable. So we go through the three stages of our life. As nobody, as body, and as somebody. In all these things, body is common. In nobody, no identification with the body. With the body identification, as the body. And with the relations, born with relation to the body, as somebody. And this somebody is the one who suffers in life. So what will be the meditation? Come to discover. The somebody is not real. The body is real. The body is not real. The nobody is real. Because even without the body identification, we continue to exist. So I am not because of the body. The body is because of me. If this principle we agree, then only the second step you will take. Otherwise you will not take. Then the second step will be, when we are sitting, now what is yoga? Yoga begins with the asana. Okay, do that, doesn't matter. Now what for the asana is done or yoga is done? Normally the people in yoga, they tell yoga for healthy body, yoga for blood pressure, yoga for heart attack, yoga for asthma. So the yoga is meant for only the health purpose and the longevity. they give you this kind of a carrot before a donkey. If you do yoga, you will remain healthy, you will live long. These are the two curses. What will you do with a healthy and long body? You live 100, 200 years. What next? See, friends, yoga is the science of spiritual evolution. Instead of that, our condition is like, in India, you all know, we have cows or buffaloes as a part of the family, in villages particularly. And what for the cows are kept? They are kept for the milk. The cow dung and urine comes free. Nobody keeps the cow for a cow dung. In the same manner, yoga is a spiritual practice. Health and longevity is a byproduct like a cow dung. But we are interested only in the cow dung. Think, friends. Therefore, when you are sitting as a yoga asana, what should be the approach? Asana is done to get rid of body identification. Like we all have come here, we have used our cars to come up to the compound of this Hindu temple. After the purpose was over, we kept the cars outside. Then with the shoes, we came up to the hall. We kept the shoes outside. Purpose was over. We came inside. Now what should we leave here? Leave all your buddies. Be a seeker. Don't come as a complaint box. You have to seek the truth. There are the same useless things. Husband is like that, wife is like that. Children are like, yaar, you get married and trouble me? Who asked you to get married? See, friends. And once you are here, now, what is the goal in the first step is we should be able to get rid out of this body identification. This is the goal. Now, next step. As you have seen this tripod of my camera, if you observe, what is the specialty of this tripod? It is steady. It is not falling down. It can remain in the same posture for hours together, years together. The reason is the center of gravity is exactly in the center. Similarly, this mic stand, it is like this because center of gravity is not displaced. It is within the area of it is occupied. Exactly the same way. When we are sitting, we have to sit like a tripod. Now, what is a tripod? If you are sitting on the floor or if you are sitting in the chair, doesn't matter. The distance between your two knees should be equal. Then the distance between the knee and the backbone should be equal. So you can just open or close your folded legs. And third and the most important thing, the weight of your body should land on the sitting bones. If you sit and you can feel the two bones are touching the floor. They are called as pin bones or the ischai bones in the medical terminology. Sit there. After you are sitting over there, then the next step comes. Where to keep the hands? Hands is the big problem. Many people tell they keep the hands in the on the knees and then they'll pull you ahead. Not that way. Keep your hands. One of the many mudras are these lower three fingers, interlock them, index finger to index finger and thumb to thumb. So in this manner, put them in your lap, not somebody else's lap. Now your back is straight. Now, goal is freedom from body identification. Now, first we will do some psychological adjustments. We are cheerful and happy. We are here by our own choice. There is no struggle. We are not here under compulsion or punishment. Second step, in our heart is our beloved Lord and Guru Maharaj. The Guru guides us from within, and our beloved Lord protects us from the within. So there is no element of fear. We are under the protection of Guru and Govinda. Then the third step, we have to drop our total past. How to drop the total past? Insist that at this moment I am Mr. Nobody, because somebody is a mule carrying the burden of the total past. Nobody has no past. So at this moment I am nobody. Three adjustments. Now the fourth adjustment. We don't plan anything what we will do after meditation. Thereby the future is blocked. So what is our position now? Neither the past nor the future bother us. Therefore, we are in the present. So if you observe your own body, you will see that your body has become firm at the base, and vertically the body is steady. Now we have to add one more parameter, that the body is fully relaxed. So the ideal asana to get out of the body identification has three attributes: firm at the base, vertically steady, and fully relaxed. So we start giving suggestions to the body to relax from the top to the toe. We will give instructions, your body will follow it, you don't worry how to do it. You must disappear between the instructions and the body. It will happen. We'll go part by part and it will happen. Relax the head muscles relax, the forehead relax, the eyebrows relax, the eyelids. Let there be no pressure on the eyeballs. The eyelids are closed softly. Don't try to see anything. Let the eyes be focused to infinite. Relax the face muscles. Relax the nose, lips, chin. Relax the ears. Relax the neck from all the four sides, the throat below the ears and the neck. Hang down the shoulders. They are unnecessarily lifted up. It is here the strong personality lives. Relax the shoulder joints. Relax the upper arms, elbows, lower arms, wrists, palms, and all the 10 fingers. Let us take a pause and see that our body is now divided in two parts, relax and not yet relax. The relaxed portions are without any muscle tension and muscle tone. The weight of our hands have increased in our lap. The index fingers and thumbs are pressing hard against each other without our efforts. The rest of the body is with tensions, muscle tones, etc. Now come back to your shoulder. Relax the chest muscles. Go slowly downwards. The abdominal area, right up to the floor. Relax the shoulder joints and from below the shoulders, go along with the sides. Relax, relax. Right up to the hip joints. Go on the back side. Start relaxing from the top of the head, back of the head, the neck, the shoulders, the thoracic back, along the spine. Go downward slowly. Relax, relax the lumbar region, the hips. Relax up to the sitting bones. Now again we pause and you will observe the weight of your body has increased on the pin bones, the sitting bones. Sometimes we may get a pulsation there. Relax the hips. Relax the hip joints. Relax the thighs, the knees. Relax calf muscles. Go downwards. Ankles, heels. Relax the toes. And get out of the body. Now in this hall there are so many bodies. There is no reason why this body I am and other bodies I am not. Just by practice it has happened. Now stand in front of your own body and take the front view. Don't forget you are outside the body. See the head, the forehead, the eyes, etc. Go down part by part slowly, right up to the base. If there are patches of tensions on the way, relax them. Go to the right side of your body. Don't forget you are outside the body. Take the right view. The right side of the head, the right ear, the right side of the neck. Go downward slowly, relaxing the final touch up to the hip joints. Let there be no patches of tensions anywhere. Now walk behind the body and take the back view of the body. Start from the top of the head, go downwards, neck, shoulders, all along the back and the spine. Go downwards, right up to the sitting bones. If there are pressures or tensions, relax them. Now go to the left side of your body. This side, the same process. But you will see there are more tensions because other three sides were relaxed. So from the top to the base, go slowly and relax, relax, relax. Now, in fact, what has happened is different. What we have understood is different. It was not the body that was relaxing. It was the mind that was relaxing. Body is never in tension. It is the mind that is under tension. and the tension of the mind is holding on to the shape of a particular body. Now if you observe the shape, the size, the contour line of your own body has become very hazy and non-distinct. And the concept of inside the body and outside the body has disappeared. Now the experience is only that of our presence. The individual mind has dissolved in the total mind. Hearing is happening, but hearer is not born. Knowledge is happening, but knower is not born. Your breathing is extremely slow and shallow. This quality of breathing is a master key for separation of the mind from the body. Do not fight with the mind. Thoughts are not the problem. When we cooperate with the thoughts and become the thinker, then the problems come. Therefore, we have to learn to be indifferent to anything, any thought that comes and goes. Nothing is good, nothing is bad. When we learn this art of remaining indifferent, the mind will cool down. And then this experience will become natural 24/7. Take deep breath 2-3 times and see how the body is now included in your mind. The shape, the size of the body is inside the mind. Move your toes and fingers. Now the concept that I am inside the body and the world is outside has become real. Offer this prayers to Lord Rama and empty yourself. Don't make this as a concept. This will never be repeated in your life. That which is repeated is matter. That which is not repeated is infinite reality. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti, 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 Hari Om, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Hari Om.